So I'm not very sure why India Today gave Kerala that award, but the 2016...
No, because on NCRB figures and other figures, Kerala does rank well.
I will show you what NCRB in 2016 said, that Kerala ranks highest in terms of crime in India. 14.5% of all crimes committed in India are in Kerala. So let's not go down that road, Mr. Balgopal, because that is an argument you won't win. But let me say this. There is something remarkably ironical about the Congress taking this position, because let us step back and understand one thing. Kerala has always had either a Congress government or a left government. Mm-hmm. There has never been a BJP government. There has never been an RSS government or any other government. These are the two parties that have institutionalized political violence and corrosion of the police force. And there is not one case today of political violence since 2000 that has been successfully prosecuted. Mr. Balgopal talks about we arrest them. Let me give you an example that I personally went through. Recently, at the height of this tutu meme between the Chief Minister and me, they unleashed 25 hooligans on a resort that one of the companies in which I'm an investor has. 25 people climb over the wall, demolish and create damages of about 8-10 crores, beat up people, and walk away. And they proudly wave the flag of the DYFI. The police, the case is filed in the police. The police choose, as is the norm with Kerala police, to pick the least strong sections of the law, charge them, and by the evening, the 25 guys are out and posting selfies on the Facebook. So that is law and order and enforcement, CPM style. Let us be clear about one thing, Rajdeep. If there is a political party in all the parties in India that firmly embeds political violence and intimidation as part of their political strategy, it is the left. Now, I don't want to get into whether Mr. Balgopal started it or Mr. Pinrai Vijayan started it or their forefathers started it. That is not my point. But the left subscribes to this kind of intimidation. And I'll even give you another answer on why they do so. You step back today and look at Kerala today. There is not one rupee of private investment that has come to the state since 2016, Mr. Pinrai Vijayan took over. Ask yourself the question, why? Which investor anywhere in the world or anywhere in the country will walk knowingly into a landscape where the police and the system stand idly by when political violence is inflicted on the street? Forget about my political affiliation. Step back and just understand why the economy of Kerala today, which is 76,000 crores of revenue, it runs a deficit of 14,000 crores, relies completely on remittances, a phenomenon that is anyway shrinking because of the pressure on the Gulf economies. There is no economic activity. When you don't have economic activity, what do? You create this violence to distract the youth, keep them busy, almost embolden them by telling the police not to interfere. And the proof is very simple. I don't subscribe to alternate facts. I don't subscribe to rhetoric. Mr. Balgopal should tell me one
case. I'm glad you're saying that given some of the television channels you run, but that's another story for another day.
That is a different panel, and I'm happy to be invited for that panel separately.
Yes.
But I am asking Mr. Balgopal or anybody in his left organization to point out to one of the murders that have been committed from 2000, which has been successfully prosecuted, and the conspiracy behind that, and the people sent to jail. If he tells me that, I will today agree that.
And the truth is, as I said, or
the Congress administration.
To be fair, Rajiv Chandrasekhar today, unlike some of the channels he may be owning, is focusing on facts, and some of those facts are vital.